Witches, it's Treehouse Idol!
Welcome back to
I'm
you.
One of the finalists.
Every little thing you do.
My
it's
mom's
so
up there too.
Dear Mr. Monkey.
My dad's best mate Wes. Three fabulous judges. And my little brother Robin.
Robin!
Stand by for the grand final of Treehouse Idol. Ta-da! Brazil. G'day world, welcome to my treehouse and the grand final of Treehouse Idol, the biggest conservation show on the earth. I'm Brian Siegel, your host for this night of all nights, with your favourite judges, Paula Cox Rule, Brian Tower, and our special guest, Polly Darton. For our first contestant, give it up for old Terry Owen.
I am an elephant of India. I am an elephant of India. Watch me sway, dressed in grey, all the way from my head to my toes. It's so hot here, Mr. Monkey. Watch me shake my tail. Swing my trunky, make the ground beat with my big grey feet. I am an elephant of India.
You know, Terry, yeah, you're going great. You're getting out there and you're doing it, were you, huh? Yeah, I mean, you're great, although not so great because of those hips. They always seem to get in the way, you know? Although you were really good, but, you know, sometimes with the singing, you weren't so good. The dancing was tops, man. But, you know, it wasn't so good either because, I mean, you kept going wham, wham, you know?
Well, Terry, I just want to say you were amazing. I mean, look at you. You're the most beautiful mouse. Perfect girl I have seen. You have the most beautiful hair. You're just amazing, and I mean, your performance was great, and I just want to say thank you so much for being on Treehouse Idol.
You know, your dance moves are really out there, I mean, on all aspects, and your singing, you've really got to get some singing lessons.
And have you looked in a mirror lately?
You're not getting to the point where I think, wow, you're actually improving. You're absolutely dreadful and on all aspects, and I don't know how you got on the show. I don't think you're gonna make it.
You hang in there, Feather. Our next entry for Treehouse Idol is a conservation piece sent in by a couple of wildlife warriors. This is a real stretch.
Have a look at this beautiful little one. This is a Goliath spider from South America, and it's the largest spider in the world. She is absolutely huge.
Oh, yeah. And they get to, like, the size of a dinner plate, which is absolutely amazing.
Big spider.
Now, this little girl can live up to 25 years of age, but we've always got to remember, do not touch any spiders at all. We're really, well, we're not, we're pretty much nearly trained professionals.
Well, well, we'll give it a go anyway.
You are anyway. Yeah, but we've done this a lot, and, they're very gorgeous, but you don't know if a spider could be venomous or could kill you or could really harm you.
Yeah. So when you see a spider, don't touch them, just admire them and walk away.
Kelly from Long Beach wants to know what it's like walking the red carpet. Well, Kelly, I had an absolute ball walking the red carpet at the Kids' Choice Awards.
Wow, what a welcome!
It was my second appearance at the Kids' Choice Awards in Sydney, Australia. My mum had a camera, so here's what all the excitement looks like from down here at my size, with all the cameras, microphones and autographs.
This is a boa constrictor and she's non-venomous. A very brave lady with a venomous cobra is our next entry in the education category.
Check this cobra out. This is a monocled cobra. This will be found in India, Sri Lanka, throughout Asia. This beautiful cobra is an albino. Usually she'd have more color. See those red eyes? Now, cobras are very venomous. They have neurotoxins in their venom, which affects your brain function. Eventually, you're not able to even breathe. If somebody accidentally stood on a cobra, they'd be in big trouble. Cobras are smart, though. Their defense mechanism is to stand up tall, hood up, say, look how big I am. Look at the monocle. See that monocle on her hood? That single circle, it looks like an eye. So if a bird of prey or a mongoose is coming in to have a go, she hoods up, and the animal thinks, whoa, I'm even being watched from behind, and they'll leave the cobra alone. Now, she's not aggressive. She's not gonna chase people. She only gets like this if she feels threatened. These are beautiful snakes, part of the ecosystem, and they're the ones that keep the reptiles and the little animals in check. Without them, we'd have a lot more disease and problems. You're a good girl.
Great work there from Terry Irwin in the conservation category.
Crikey! Did you know that a ton of recycled paper saves 17 trees?
A man who can't sing, dance, or entertain next on Treehouse Idol. Our second finalist in the Treehouse Idol is a man who should really stick to reptiles. A man who really needs no introduction because you'll never see him again.
When the hippo moves her hips, the monkey just flips. The lion's hypnotized, can't believe his eyes when the hippo moves her hips. When the hippo moves her hips, the mountains shift. And we're all surprised at the size of those thighs when the hippo moves her hips. She scares the supermodels when they see the way that she waddles. It'll curl your lips when the hippo moves her hips.
Whoa, Wes, that was just awful. That was just awful, man. I mean, come on. Check it out, you know, y'all. But it was great, though. You know, you were doing great, great work with your singing, but some of it wasn't good. Although, some of it was good. Whoa, boing, 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 loo. Keep it on the ground, you heard? Keep it down. And check out that nose, man. That nose has got to go. Although, it does help for breathing.
Your dances are just, whoa. They're cutting edge, but they're still great. They're fitting in so well. You're just a great looking man. You're just perfect. Whoever said you were bad, they are totally wrong. You're great, you're perfect.
Well, Wes, I mean, you know, first of all, your singing is absolutely, it's awful.
I mean, Khaki, it's so last season. Your hairdo.
Hello, wake up. This isn't 19th century.
You're awful. You're not going to make it, man.
Hey, Peru. This is Treehouse Idol, and I'm Ryan Siegel, your idol. Bindi's idol is her friend Abigail Rislin. She visited Australia Zoo when she was filming her movie, Nim's Island.
Hi, hello, how are ya?
Good, how are you?
Very good.
So glad to meet you.
So you are working with a lot of animals?
Yes, I am.
Awesome, well, I do work with and play with a lot of animals as well. Maybe I could teach you a bit. Would you like to go see them?
Cool, that would be awesome.
There's a few different animals in the movie, so we're introducing Abigail to some of our more famous Australian zoo wildlife. Dingoes are Australia's version of the wolf. These girls are friendly as puppies, but wild dingoes can be really dangerous. Minibus the wombat is just so cute. She gets to greet a lot of visitors at the zoo. This is Flower. What a great name for a boy alligator. And he's amazingly calm for a crocodilian. Tigers and keepers stay together as a permanent team. In the wild, they would be hunting and moving all the time. We make up for that with games. The tigers end up getting the same exercise they get in the wild. Brazil is a South American green iguana. He's always up in my treehouse. This very rare white Burmese python is from the jungles of Southeast Asia, and so are Siam, Sabu, and Bimbo. This is the only place in Australia where you can hand feed elephants and get sneezed on at the same time. I'm glad Abigail didn't get slimed by my elephant. I just love introducing new friends to my favourite animals at Australia Zoo. Because when people love animals, they might just turn into wildlife warriors.
He's small, but he packs a punch. Robert's next.
Squeeze.
It takes nerves of steel, tons of courage, and heaps of talent to be a finalist on this show. And next is our youngest and smallest songster of all ever, Robert Irwin.
Hey, come on, get down with me. I'm
R-O-B-E-I-T.
But don't you try and mess around with me.
I'm R-O-B-E-I-T.
So cute, man. You know, Jake, you're my little man. You know, woo! But, you know, some of it was mad cute. I mean, cute doesn't get you everywhere, you know, but cute's not what I'm all about. But I love it. You know, man, whoa, check it. You know, us boys got to stick together, you know, word. But, I mean, you know, you're dancing, we're like, woo, 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 woo. I'm Robert, R-O-B-E-R-T, you know, word. Man, you know, check it.
Oh my goodness, Robert Irwin, look at you, my darling. You're just so cute. You know, your dances are so cute. You're at the dancing. You're just gorgeous. And your song, whoa, a lot of effort as well. I mean, I can really see that coming out in you. You are just the cutest little thing ever. And I am so glad to have you on Treehouse Idol. You're just amazing.
Wow, Robert, I mean, you know, your t-shirt and everything, you look very cute, but I mean, really, you can get cute past your mom and cute past your sister, but you ain't getting cute past me. I mean, you're just like a wooden man. You're like, you gotta loosen up, dude, loosen up, don't be so wooden, you know? The microphone's bigger than you are. Yeah, you're a little too short for this industry. So, you know, you're cute and everything, but really, I can see those little horns broken up there, you know? Mm-hmm.
Michael from Los Angeles has asked, why are snakes so brightly coloured? Well, Michael, it's usually for camouflage or to warn off predators. Check out these amazing colours of these snakes.
Have Have a go at all these different colored snakes. Aren't they beautiful? These guys vary from South America to North America. It's absolutely, hello, amazing. I've got snakes everywhere. I guess I'm like Medusa. But if you have a look at all the different sorts of colors, orange, black, white.
We've got milk snakes. Whoa, and king snakes.
Man, I need to get another person to help me hold these, or I need 8 arms. All these snakes are completely harmless, but just remember, never touch a snake.
The wildlife warriors who sent in the spider clip have also sent the following clip showing their bravery with scorpions. These two are really stretching it.
Have a look at these little guys. These are emperor scorpions from Africa. Now, they look pretty scary, but they're not like some scorpions, which can be quite dangerous. Here, do you want to hold that one? Oh, that's a girl.
Yeah.
Now, these guys are one of the largest in the world. One of the good ways to tell whether a scorpion is dangerous is the dangerous ones have really small pinchers and a really big fat tail. And that's because the pointy end, the sharp end, is the one that does all the damage. The most important thing to remember is never ever touch these guys, because once again it's hard to work out whether the animal is a dangerous one or not. And once again, if you have a look at this, you don't want to get whacked by that. So whatever you do, have a look at them, but don't play with them.
Woo! Our final contestant, Mindy Irwin,
is just ahead.
Are you trying to hide, Squeeze?
The moment we've all been waiting for. Our final contestant in the Treehouse Idol. A girl who's a legend in her own treehouse. The most perfect little girl in the world. It's Bindi Irwin. Give it up for her. Check it out, man. Woo! Your dancer was like, oh my goodness. It was like, you know, like, ooh, yeah. But it wasn't coming across very good. It was just kind of like you kept pulling back, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, check it, you know? Woo! Try and keep your feet on the ground, you know, man. Check it. The hair, not so much. I mean, pigtails, so 3-year-old. I mean, really, you know. You go, girl, you know, check it, you go. Wow, Aunt Bindi, you know, you've got cute hair and everything, but I mean, crimping, it's the 80s, come on. Think about it, you're putting old back in and old just doesn't go anymore, man. And I mean, your clothes, it's just not exactly perfect. I mean, yellow t-shirt, brown pants, doesn't exactly go together, I'm sorry to say. Try and loosen up a bit. Come on, get into the rhythm, you know?
Oh my goodness, Bindi Irwin, hey! You're pretty, you're a young little lady now, aren't you? Now, my darling, your singing is coming along great, my little lady.
And I mean, your dinosaur, hello, hello, hello. You know, your dad's great at this treehouse idol thing. And I love the hair, girl. I wish I could get mine like that, except I probably have to dye it long. You're just so pretty. You're a real little lady.
The best treehouse idol was my dad talking about wildlife on stage because no one could vote him off.
If you've ever wondered what it would be like to fly around the US of A in a private jet promoting a movie and spending 12 to 14 hours every day talking to journalists, well, you're about to find out. G'day, Sacramento!
My mum and dad did 1,200 interviews in just 2 weeks. They were flat out like a lizard drinking with every imaginable talk show across the USA.
G'day, New York! Woo!
Great. Looking good, Matilda. What a stretch of a show. Well, that's a wrap for the grand final. Give a big treehouse round to our special judges, Paula, Brian, and Polly, for doing such an out there job. Conservation medals go to our runners up, Wes, for handling snakes better than a song, Terry, for turning up, Robert, for looking cute, of course. Well, that is it for the grand final of Treehouse Idol. But the biggest one goes to the littlest wildlife warrior of all, the cutest, most gorgeous, most perfect girl in the universe, Bindi Sue Irwin. Seagull signing off. And did I say she's gorgeous hair? She's got the most gorgeous hair ever. Well, we'll see you next time for more fun in the jungle. See ya.
Some growing to do, little girl.
Yeah, she's got a big fat abdomen. You can see a little abdomen there.
Wes, are you actually supposed to say that to a girl spider?
True. She's got a
very small, cute little abdomen.
Very small, cute little abdomen. And have a look. I'll see if I can get her up here a little bit. She's got these huge fangs in here. Wow, and they're around about, look at that. They're about the size of a pencil. I tell you what, you would not want to get grabbed by.
Because, I mean, if they're as big as a tip of a pencil tip, they're fangs that would pretty hurt while they're biting you.
They would absolutely hurt. But you can see, she's pretty gentle, really. Now, these guys come from South America, and they live in the rainforest. And pretty much they'll often live at the base of trees. They'll eat anything that comes near them. Let's say a baby bird dropped there, boom, they just go whoosh, 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 grab hold of it with those big fangs, they drive them into the animal and kills them quite quickly. Physically doing a lot of damage just by the actual bite. Now, insects is probably their main diet. They're pretty much opportunistic. Another amazing thing about these guys, I'll just grab this little barb here. As you can see, now let go. Right under there, you'll see that little little thing called a pectine.
Stop
you
it.
See it there? It's like a little.
Hey, don't pinch me.
He's pinching me, dude.
You see?
Stop pinching me.
No pinching. Oh, okay. He's gonna zap me in a minute. He's like, I've had enough
mine,
of you.
Mine is too.
Here, let me take him. Come over here with your mate. You'll be much happier. There you go.